A non-denominational Bible Institute founded as part of the Christian Education Department of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries Incorporated, based in Waycross, Georgia. BLBI has expanded now with an on-site campus in Kenya. Our mission is to equip men and women of God to be productive and functioning parts of the local body of Christ. VLBI provides affordable biblical education and leadership training for ministers, professionals, and laypersons. We will provide you with the skills, education, and character needed to effectively serve, equip, and shape the lives of others as they pursue excellence in Christian education, ministry, and leadership. Study on site at our Waycross campus or online in our Learning Center. Visit www.victoriouslbi.org. Call 1-833-884-8880.
Command your morning with Evangelist Renee Sellers on the Prayer Line, Monday through Friday, beginning at 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. and 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, with devotion, prayer, and pronouncement of daily affirmations. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see. Dial 1-712-770-4010. Using access code 266-590. That's 1-712-770-4010 using access code 266-590. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see on the Prayer Line with Evangelist Renee Sellers.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. This is Evangelist Renee Sellers of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries in Waycross, Georgia, and we are live at 5 this morning for this Command Your Morning broadcast. I know a lot of you stayed up late like we did watching the Super Bowl, and congratulations to the Kansas City Chiefs and Tariq Hill from Pearson, Georgia. Amen. We're excited for you all today. I'm trying to find out if we're related. Amen. To God be the glory. But congratulations to the Kansas City Chiefs on a win last night for Super Bowl. I think reports showed that it had been 50 years. So thank God for this win on last night. And we're thankful today for those that are joining us on the call this morning. This truly is another day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's Motivational Monday, and we're coming to motivate you this morning with the word love. This is 3rd of February, 2020. This is the month where we celebrate love. And we're going to talk about that agape God kind of love today. We're going to go to 1 Corinthians 13. We're going to be looking at Galatians chapter 5. We're going to be in 1 Corinthians chapter 12. So I encourage you to get your Bibles, get your pens and pads, and let's get ready to go to work. We're excited to be coming to you on WHLJ 97.5 FM, 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. We're also online this morning at foxy97.com, and you can join us on the conference call with these awesome men and women of God as they are coming in at 712-770-4010, access code 266-590. There'll be a recap that I believe you'll want to get at 7 p.m. tonight on WHLJ. So we're going to get right on into it this morning, and I am going to ask, Pastor Gloria Moore Wright this morning to open our broadcast with a word of prayer.
Okay. Holy Father, we bless you today. God, we give you honor, we give you praise, and we thank you for waking us up this morning with you on our minds. Thank you for blessing us in a down-sitting and an uprising. Lord God, we give you glory, and we thank you for Upper Room Ministries. We thank you for Command Your Morning Ministry. We commit it to you today, God, and we pray, God, that you will use this, your servant, in a great and mighty way. Help us to hide your words in our hearts that we might not sin against you. Bless all ministries that are represented on this call, those that are in the listening audience. Father, we ask blessings upon WHLJ and Mr. Lee. We pray, God, that you would continue to use this broadcast to evangelize the world. Lord God, we thank you for all things, the good and the bad, the rough and the tough. We ask, God, that you would have mercy and compassion on us today. Forgive us of all of our sins, all of our transgressions, our shortcomings and our weaknesses, Father. We lift up all that are in need of prayer, and we ask, God, that you will bless them right now. Look on the sick and heal them, Father. Look on the bereaved and comfort them, God. Lord God, look on our youth, O God, and be with them, O God, as they go to and from school, Father. Dispatch your angels to watch over them and protect them, Father. In Jesus' name, all that are traveling today, God, we pray travel mercies for them, that you would keep them hedged in and protected. And God, we would continue to give you glory. We would continue to give you honor and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. Thank you so much, Pastor Gloria Moright. Let's talk about love this morning. That's my subject. My subject this morning. Let's talk about love. We're going to look at 1 Corinthians chapter 12 of the New King James Version of the Bible. We're going to start at verse 27. Now, you are the body of Christ, and members individually. And God has appointed these in the church: first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healings, helps, administrations, varieties of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Are all workers of miracles? Do all have gifts of healings? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? But earnestly desire the best gifts, and yet I show you a more excellent way. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, starting at verse 1, verses 1 through 8, New King James. Though I speak with the tongues, and the subheading here in what I'm looking at is the greatest gift. And so we have a lot of spiritual gifts, and I'll talk about that in a minute. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. So as we talk about love this morning, one thing we have to understand is it's amazing the way the Apostle Paul and Holy Spirit had him to write 1 Corinthians 12, 13, and 14. 1 Corinthians 12 outlines the spiritual gifts, the supernatural gifts, the unity of these gifts in the body of Christ. We talked about those in depth over the last few weeks. And then he goes to verse 14, and he talks about order. He gives us prophecy and tongues. He talks about order in the church, and he tells us to do all things decently in order, most specifically as it relates to tongues and prophecy. And so in 13, right in the middle of these two chapters, 1 Corinthians 12 and 1 Corinthians 14, is the book that we talk about love. And I know a lot of times that we use this scripture to talk about marriage, and we apply this to marriage and general love of people, and that's okay to apply it. Scripture, as it relates to scripture, there's one interpretation, but many applications. So you can apply this in multiple ways. But Paul is telling us how we are, at what we should be motivated by as we use our spiritual gifts. In 1 Corinthians 13, let me show you a more excellent way. Well, that excellent way, if you move on to verse chapter 13, is love. He begins to talk about love. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, and though I have the gift of prophecy and have not love, although I can bestow goods to feed the poor and have not love, the goal and the motivation for using our spiritual gifts is love. The greatest gift, ladies and gentlemen, is love. Galatians chapter 5 and verse 6, in the New King James Version, it says that for in Christ Jesus neither circumcision nor uncircumcision avails anything, but faith working through love. So even though for when we are in union with Christ, neither circumcision nor the lack of it makes any difference. It doesn't make any difference what Paul is trying to tell them in Ephesians. In Galatians, it makes no difference about uncircumcision or circumcision. What really matters is faith that works through love. And so a lot of people today are not missing it in their knowledge of the Word of God. There are people that know the Word of God like the back of their hand. There's some alcoholics that know the Word of God. It's on the street corner. Never go to church, but they know the Word of God. And a lot of people today in the church are not missing it in their confession of faith, and they're not missing it in their belief in the Word of God. A lot of people today are missing it in their love walk. I need somebody to write that down and say amen. A lot of people, listen, we know the Word. We can prophesy till the house is packed. We can demonstrate and all these, administrate and all these different things, but we're missing it in our love walk, ladies and gentlemen. We're missing it because a lot of people are in church, but they're not walking in the love of Jesus Christ. Did I say that, Pastor Wright? I'm not going to take it back. There are a lot of people today, watch this now, I've experienced it, and you have too. You've experienced people that can preach until the shingles, listen, preach the shingles off the building, but they're people that they simply don't like. They're preaching and the house will be packed out, but the person will come in and have a need and they'll turn their back on them. I've seen it. I've seen people come in and I'm like, it just shook me when I saw this one day. Person walked in and had just had a service and somebody walked in with a need and didn't even respond to the need. Didn't even say, let me see if somebody else can help you. Let me, there's somebody down the street. If I can't help you, ladies and gentlemen, as members of the body of Christ, if we can't help somebody, send them to somebody who can, or at least trying to figure out if their need is real. I know people come in and they try to get over on the church. It happens all the time. But are we willing to at least try to figure out if their need is real? And so we're missing it, ladies and gentlemen, in our love and not walking in the love of God. Where's your love walk today? I just read 1 Corinthians 13, verse 1 and 8, and it describes and gives the characteristics of not just any kind of love, but what we call agape love, and it's that God kind of love, that love that is unconditional, that love that is everlasting, that love we're gonna talk about those descriptions. Love, first of all, we got to understand that love is not an option. I was gonna minister on love yesterday, but love is not an option. It's a command. John chapter 13, verse 34. Love is not an option. It is a command. John 13 and 34. It says in the New King James Version, it says, a new commandment I give you. A new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Somebody needs to stick a pen in a new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. I want you to stick a pen in a new commandment I give you. And then I want you to highlight or underline, as I have loved you. Because what Jesus is saying, the question is, I was going to ask this yesterday, how is this a new commandment? When the same words are written in the Old Testament book of Leviticus 19:18, how is this a new commandment when we've seen this before? Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18, Miranda, it says, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. So what's new, Brother Harris, about what Jesus is commanding us to do? What's new about this commandment? Well, let me tell you. While Leviticus says, love thy neighbor, what makes this a new commandment in John chapter 13 is the fact that Jesus is adding, as I have loved you. And so Jesus is saying, I don't want your love for each other to be superficial. This new commandment that I give you, ladies and gentlemen, requires you to lay down your life for your neighbor. This new commandment that I give you requires you to make sacrifices. This new commandment that I give you, ladies and gentlemen, requires you to lay down your life just as I, Jesus, laid down my life. That means that it doesn't matter how another person acts. I am commanded to love them. It doesn't matter how nasty their attitude is, ladies and gentlemen. I am commanded to love them. It doesn't matter how many tricks and games they run on us. We are commanded to love them. That doesn't mean you let people run all over you, but you gotta love, because you gotta love yourself enough not to do that. But it does mean that even when we are mistreated, we won't gossip about them. We won't tell other people, listen, how they treated us, trying to make them look bad. I won't scandalize their name all over Facebook and Instagram. As a matter of fact, listen, we need to, this morning, you need to look at somebody this morning and say, love me enough to tell me what I did, and don't just assume that I know what I did. Part of the problem with a lot of people is they want us to read their minds, and they think we should know to apologize. Love says, listen, this thing works both ways. If you don't want to come to me and resolve the issue, I am coming to you. If you won't come to me and tell me what's wrong, I'm coming to you. As a matter of fact, I believe it was yesterday I read the scripture. Let me go there this morning, that when you got an ought against another individual, it's not just their job to come to us. It's our job to go to them. Leave your gift at the altar and be reconciled. Let's look at Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5, somewhere around verse 24. This thing is so serious, because I truly believe that Jesus is getting ready to receive the church, those that are born again, those true believers, those true followers of Jesus Christ. And now is the time to demonstrate true agape love more than ever before. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is the season to love, and love hard. You got to love hard. I'm telling you, do we really know what love is? Do we really know what true, genuine love is? I know, you know, we look at people in the church sometimes, and I've heard people say, well, that person got issues. And my response to that was, that's why the church is there. That person got a lot of problems. And some people say, well, they got so many problems, they don't want to deal with them, that individual, because of their issues. But that's why the church is there. That's why the body of Christ, oh God, watch this now. That's why the body of Christ exists. Because, listen, at one point, you were one with issues. And somebody in the church had to minister to your issues. So why is it now that we're in the church and we got a position in the church that we don't want to help other people with theirs? Let me leave that alone. Let me go to Matthew chapter 5, verse 23. Let me go here. It says, therefore, if you bring your gift to the altar, and there remember that your brother has something against you. Let me say that again. And there remember that your brother has something against you. Let me say this. Each person is responsible for obeying the word of God. We are personally responsible for walking in obedience to the word of God. And so I believe that if everybody obeyed this, then not only will you be going to them, but at the same time, they'll be coming to you. It says, and there remember that your brother has something against you. Leave your gift there before the altar and go your way. First, be reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Agree with your adversary quickly. I talked about time yesterday. And so we must deal with these things and not hesitate to deal with these things. Love says, I want to get it over with. Love says, I'm ready to deal with this because I want to be reconciled to my brother. If it be possible, scripture says, be at peace with all men. I know there are some people that you may not be able to get to resolve issues with, but at least when you take steps to do it, you'll be at peace with yourself and you'll be at peace with God. I need somebody to help me make peace this morning. So this morning, as we talk about love, love is a commandment. Jesus is saying, a new commandment I give you because I want you to love the way I love. The love that Jesus Christ has for us is selfish, is sacrificial. But so many people these days are selfish and selfless. I hope I said selfless, not selfish. The love of Jesus Christ is selfless and sacrificial. But a lot of people these days are selfish and puffed up with pride that they don't want to love the way Jesus loved. They don't want to forgive. And so, like I said yesterday, loving people from a distance, I understand where that comes from. I do understand the dilemma. Because there are people that you need to take a break from certain people for your own sanity. I understand that. But don't be so distant that when the opportunity comes to win them to Jesus, that you miss the opportunity. That's what love is. Don't be so distant that when the opportunity to come for you to say, hey, I know what you're dealing with. I'm here to minister to that need, that you miss the opportunity. Faith works through love. Love is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit. Romans chapter 5, verse 5. Am I passionate? Do I sound passionate about that this morning? I know I do, because I am. Now, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Let me say that again. The love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. And so all of us, because God has given us the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit fills our hearts with his love. Therefore, can I ask a question? If we have issue with love and we are struggling in our love walk, are we truly filled with the Spirit of God? That's a question I need to take a pause on after I ask it. If we're struggling to demonstrate the love of Jesus Christ, are we truly filled with the Holy Spirit? Because Galatians chapter 5 would have us to understand that the Holy Spirit produces love. The Holy Spirit tells the Galatians 5:22, the first attribute of being filled with the Holy Spirit, of what the Holy Spirit produces, is love. And so love is fulfilling the law, Romans 13:10. Love is fulfilling the law, Romans 13:10, New King James Version of the Bible. Let's go back a little bit to verse 8 of Romans 13, New King James. It says, owe no one anything except to love one another, for he who loves another has fulfilled the law. For the commandments you shall not commit, for the commandments you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not covet. If there is any other commandment, all are summed up in saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Watch this. Love does no harm to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. Let me say this. When we truly have the love of Jesus Christ and we truly love other people, adultery would not be named among us. Murder would not be named among us. Stealing would not be named among us. Lying about each other would not be named among us. Being covetous would not be named among us. Why? Because love is the highest goal. And when we truly have the love of Jesus Christ, we would not be entertaining these behaviors. When we truly have the love of Jesus Christ, these things would not be named among us. And so love is fulfilling the law. Love is the catalyst that gives meaning to speaking in tongues. And that's why 1 Corinthians 13 is sandwiched between. Listen, 1 Corinthians 13 is your peanut butter and jelly. 1 Corinthians 12 and 14 is your bread. And so thereby they're sandwiched between. 1 Corinthians 13 is sandwiched between the spiritual gifts and order and using and the misuse of tongues and prophecy. And so this is your peanut butter and jelly. And I know a lot of people love peanut butter and jelly, so I encourage you to study these three chapters in depth. Love is the catalyst that gives meaning to speaking in tongues and to prophesying and to understanding and faith and to works and to self-sacrifice. Love is the catalyst, 1 Corinthians 13 tells us. Love is kind, 1 Corinthians 13 and 4. Love is greater than faith, 1 Corinthians 13 and 13. Love is greater than faith. It says, and now abide faith, hope, love, these three. Let me say it again. I got to highlight it, and I hope you do too after today. Faith, hope and love abide, but the greatest of these is love. So many times we see this on the back of wedding programs, but does that couple really understand what love is? So many times we'll quote this scripture and we'll do so and just out of the blue just quote it. But do we really understand what love is? Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Do we really understand that love is, if the love of Jesus Christ is ministering to people that are, that listen, one of the reasons that I have observed, and I know that there are a lot of people that work with children, but children oftentimes, a lot of times people, you know, we don't want to deal with a lot of children, even in ministry. You know, we don't want to pick up the, you know, the difficult children. And, you know, the children are the future of the church. Somebody has to work with them. I know places that stopped working with children because they became so difficult. They stopped picking them up. They stopped dealing with them because it became so difficult. One of the things that we need to have more people that are willing to work with children, because somebody needs to help develop them into ministry leaders. Somebody has to do it. And love says, I'm going to work with the most difficult people. Love says, I'm not afraid to work with the drunkard. I'm not afraid to work with a prostitute. I won't judge her, because watch this now. Many times you'll find that women are working and they're selling their bodies, and because something happened to them at childhood that they're still struggling with. But how many of us are going to love them enough to ask them what happened? A lot of people are drunkards and alcoholics because this thing is a generational issue. There's a root to this. But how many of us are willing to help them overcome their addiction? Love is willing to do whatever it takes to meet the needs of other people. Can I say that again? You might want to write that down. Love would do whatever it takes to meet the needs of other people. Love is greater than hope. Love is a fruit of the Spirit. Galatians 5:22. Love is the bond of perfectness. Colossians chapter 3, verse 14. Do we really know what love is? I know a lot of times we think we do, but Scripture is trying to help us understand what love really is. That's what I'm trying to help us understand. What love really is. But above all these things, let's go back a little bit to verse 12. The heading here is the character of the new man. And the word man here is general for believers, the new believer. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. One of the characteristics of the last days is people will be unforgiving. And you are finding this in the church. And this is one of the reasons that a lot of times it seems like we're recycling members because somebody got mad at another church and they decided to leave and go to another church. I'm not saying that there may not be sometimes reasons or God is saying time for you to move on, but when we decide that I'm just going to up and leave because I got offended, I'm going to up and leave because I don't like the way the pastor did that, I'm going to up and leave because Sister Susie didn't do something right, if we say we're going to leave a ministry and we have those reasons for leaving and we leave mad, we say we love Jesus, then Jesus commands us to love each other. And we should love our pastors enough to say, Pastor, can I talk to you for a minute? There's something that I don't agree with. We should love our sister enough to say, Sister Susie, listen, woman of God, I got an issue with something. Can we sit down and talk? We should not be church hopping out of anger. Did I just say that? I did. And I'm not going to take it back because it's true. Mr. Lee, you praying for me this morning. We should not be, Pastor Wright, come by to pray for Evangelist Sellers. We should not be going from church. This is happening all the time. This happens so much that we get angry and we leave. And part of that leaving out of anger is an unforgiving spirit. We left and I don't want to forgive them for what they did. I'm walking away. I'm offended. Bearing with one another. This is the character of the new man. And so if we're not forgiving one another, and forgiveness should be easy for the believer. I know somebody say, well, really, Evangelist Sellers, are you really saying that? Yes, I'm saying it. Because when you are filled with the Holy Spirit, when you are filled with the love of Jesus Christ, forgiveness is not hard. Somebody said, let me take a quick break before I share my little testimony. We're live at 5, and Evangelist is feeling real good this morning. I love this subject on love. We're live at 5 on WHLJ, 97.5 FM. 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. We're also online at Foxy, FOXY97.com. And you can join us on the call at 712-770-4010. Access code 266-590. There'll be a recap tonight at 7 p.m. on WHLJ. Just the other week, someone said something to me that it hurt my feelings. But it was like Holy Spirit wouldn't even let me get mad. What that person said to me, the average individual probably would have walked away and just like, did you really just say that to me? Would have just walked away out of anger and probably never would have spoke to them again. Holy Spirit, watch this now, loves us so much that there are times when we want to be mad, we can't be mad because God, the Holy Spirit, listen, would not allow us to go there. And so it was said to me, and I began to think about it. I was like, wow, did you really just say that to my face? You really just, I mean, it broke my heart, but I couldn't get mad, but but in that particular incident, I'm careful, and I'm attentive, and I'm listening now. I know how that individual really feels about me. And sometimes if you listen to people long enough, you'll know how people really feel about you. But watch this. Even when you discover how people really feel about you, you still have a command and obligation to love them. I couldn't even get mad. The Holy Spirit wouldn't let me go there. Was I hurt? Yes. Did I get angry? No. Holy Spirit won't let us, even when some things that we feel should make us angry as believers, the world would say, I'm going to, ooh, if you say that to me again. But for the believer, it's like, okay, let's move on. You may want to say, why did you say that? Or you may want to be like, okay, I don't even want to entertain it. Let's go forward. And so the scripture says in Colossians 3, bearing with one another and forgiving one another if anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave, we must also forgive. Put up with each other. Forgive one another, even those that do you wrong. Put up for one another. We are the body of Christ. We're brothers and sisters in Christ. We are bound together by the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ died, gave up his life for the church, and he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. And so, ladies and gentlemen, this is the season that love must be our highest goal. Love must be the motivator, and it must be the biggest motivator. Put up with each other. And forgive anyone who does you wrong. Anybody, ladies and gentlemen. Verse 14 of Colossians 3 says, but above all these things, put on love. Above all these things, put on love. What does that mean? Love must be more important than anything else. And in the beginning of, in February, I know that, you know, a lot of people, you know, we buy flowers on Valentine's Day. We send those that we love flowers and candy. We buy gifts on Valentine's Day. Well, you can give the gift of love every day. And it doesn't always have to be something that is tangible. You can, there are acts of love. Love is what it does. And there are acts of love. Our women are doing something now where we are, I'm not going to say it because I don't want them to know what we're doing. But anyway, we're doing something now. We ladies are doing something that to demonstrate this love to our spouses every single day. And we don't start in February. We don't end in February. This is something that should be ongoing. But there's something specific that we're doing in that area. Love is more important than anything else. It is what ties everything completely together. It's more important. It's the bond of perfection. And verse 15 says, and let the peace of God rule your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. We have to stop right here. This has been so good, but we're going to continue to mark. Love is of God. It has its source in God. Why? Because God is love. First John, I want you to, Colossians chapter 3 just really ministered to me, so highlight that this morning and go back and study it more in depth. Bearing with one another and forgiving one another if anyone has a complaint against another. Even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. Love is more important than anything else. Let's stop right here with Colossians. We'll stop right here. We're going to go into prayer. And somebody needs to say, let's talk about love. That's our conversation for the next few days. Let's talk about love. And as we close our broadcast and go into prayer, we're not closing the broadcast, we're transitioning into prayer. I am going to ask Evangelist Darlene Gant to take us in with a word of prayer. I just found out. Never mind, I'll tell those to those on the call that just got an exciting text. But to God be the glory. Evangelist Darlene Gant, take us in with a word of prayer. God bless you. Stay on the call so you can hear my good news.
Father God, we come before you this morning, Father. We praise you. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness and your tender mercies. Father, we commit our ways today, Father, to you so that you can direct our path. Father, we glorify you, Father, for your worthy, Father. Oh, Father, we know that you are our refuge and our strength, and we know that all your thoughts towards us are good and to bring us to an expected end. Father, we pray today that you will help us, Father, to not have a spirit of fear, Father, not to walk in fear, but to walk, Father, in faith. Walk by faith, believing every word, Father, that you have spoken, Lord. Heavenly Father, we cast down all imaginations, Father, and every thought that tries to exalt itself against the knowledge of God. Heavenly Father, we pray to walk in obedience to you, Father. Father, give us ears that are sensitive to hear you when you speak, Lord. Oh, Father, let our eyes be open, Father, that we will ever be able to see, Father, what you would have us to see and discern, Father. So we pray, Father, for the gift of discernment today, Father. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father, to give us wisdom, Father. Wisdom, Father, so that we'll make wise decisions, Father. Oh, Father, we seek you early this morning, Father. We thank you, Lord, for your your loving kindness, for watching over us, Father, as we slumbered and we slept, Lord. Oh, Father, we praise you, Father, for you're such a good and loving God. Oh, Father, we could do nothing without you, Lord. Heavenly Father, so we are seeking you early this morning, Father. Oh, Father, we're not leaning to our own understanding, Father. Oh, Father, but we're depending on you, Lord, to guide us, Father. Oh, Father, through this day, Father, we pray today, Father, for hearts of repentance, Father. Oh, Father, if anything that's in our mind and our thoughts, Father, that is not clean and pure, Father, we ask you, Lord, to cleanse us, Father, to bring it to our attention, Father, that we can repent, Father. Oh, Father, we want to be able to walk in this day, a brand new day, Father. Oh, Father, we want to have a sensitive ear to hear you, Father. Heavenly Father, we ask you today, Father, oh, Father, we pray that we be careful with the words that we speak out of our mouths, Lord. Oh, Father, we want you to be pleased with the fruit of our lips, God. Heavenly Father, we praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, and we give you the glory, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you today, Father, look down upon our families, Father. Oh, Father, strengthen us, Father, that we stand, Father. Oh, Father, that we demonstrate love, Father. Oh, Father, have hearts of forgiveness, Father. Oh, Father, that others will see and know, Father, that we really, Father, represent you, my God. Heavenly Father, you today, Father, to let the unity be, Father, unbroken, Father. Oh, Father, forgiving hearts, Father. Oh, Father, demonstrating love, Father. Oh, Father, being a help, Father, wherever we can, Father. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, hallelujah, for this opportunity, Father. We thank you, Lord, Father, for this day, Father, that you have made, Father. We will rejoice and be glad in it, Lord. Oh, Father, we thank you and we praise your name, Father. We ask you to bless our children today, Father, all of our children and grandchildren. Father, watch over them and keep them safe, Lord. We thank you, Father, for all that you've done, Father. Oh, Father, keep with our children, Father. Oh, Father, we need you, Lord, to loose your angels to be with our children as they go to school today, our grandchildren, Lord. Heavenly Father, watch over them, Father, when they leave our homes, Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray for safe travels, Father. We pray for safety in the schoolhouse, Lord. Heavenly Father, let your angels be in the hallways on the school grounds, Father. Oh, Father, we pray that no violence will erupt, Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray that our children will walk in obedience, Lord, to what we have taught them, the instructions that we have given, Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray, Father. Oh, Father, we understand, Father, evil is all around, Father. Heavenly Father, so we know that your angels, Father, your warring angels, Father, we ask you to send them, Lord. Oh, Father, keep our children safe, Father. Oh, Father, we pray today for all of our unsaved family members, Father. All of those, Father, that don't know you're a part of this sin, Father. Oh, Father, that being blinded by sin, Father. Heavenly Father, we ask you today, Father, to draw them, Father. Oh, Father, we're praying, Father, that we can say something or do something, Lord. Father, that they will see and know that we serve the Most High God. Huh? Oh, Father, lead us on how to talk to people, Father. Lead us on how to demonstrate, hallelujah, the love, hallelujah. Oh, Father, that you have for us, Father. Oh, Father, we pray today, Father, that the day that they hear your voice, they harden not their hearts against the Lord. Heavenly Father, we cry out for the unsaved souls today, Father. Heavenly Father, for we know, Father, that one day, hallelujah, oh, Father, your son Jesus is coming back, huh? And he's coming back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, and we know, Lord, hallelujah, oh, Father, that we don't want to see no souls lost. Huh? Heavenly Father, so we asking you today, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, for your mercy. Huh? Oh, Father, for another day of your mercy, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, and give us the wisdom on what to say and how to say it, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, to witness to him, Lord. Huh? Oh, Father, we're crying out today, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, we don't want to see him, Father, turned away, Father, from what is right, Father. We want him to come to you, Lord. Huh? Oh, Father, with a humble heart, Father, come willing, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we realize, hallelujah, oh, Father, that Christ did it all for us, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, he did everything, huh? On the Calvary's cross, Father, the blood of Jesus is precious, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we want, hallelujah, today, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, to give you all the glory. Huh? Oh, Father, we give you all the honor, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord. Huh? Oh, Father, for your son, Jesus Christ. And we thank you, Jesus. Huh? Oh, for all that you did for us, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, we praise you today, Father. Heavenly Father, we magnify your name. Huh? Oh, Father, we pray today, Father, for all of those that are abused. Huh? All of those those that are mistreated, my God. Huh? All of those, Father, hallelujah. Oh, Father, that are feeling unsafe today, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, they've been taken away in human trafficking, Lord. Huh? Oh, Father, in sex trafficking, our young girls, our young boys. Huh? Oh, Father, we're crying out today. Huh? Oh, Father, we ask you, Lord, hallelujah. Oh, Father, release those captives. Huh? Let them return home to their families. Huh? Uncover all the dirt and the filth, hallelujah. Oh, Father, the enemy has set up. Huh? Oh, Father, uncover, hallelujah, all of those, hallelujah. Oh, Father, that are guilty, hallelujah, for you are a just God. Huh? Heavenly Father, we are praying, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, that they'll come on home, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we're praying today, Father, that you'll remove those that are being emotionally abused. Huh? Oh, Father, physically abused. Huh? Out of the abusive situations, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we're praying today, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, for safety in the homes. Huh? Safety in the communities, my God. Huh? We're praying for mothers and fathers to take a stand. Huh? Oh, Father, against the violence. Huh? We're praying for churches to take a stand. Huh? Oh, Father, lead us and guide us on how to go out into our communities, Father, huh? And what we ought to say and what we ought to do, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we don't want to be idle, my God. Huh? But, Father, we want to be obedient unto your will, my God. Huh? Heavenly Father, we pray, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, that your will is done, huh? In us, Father. Oh, Father, we know, Father, that you're able to do all things, Father. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father, to restore marriages, huh? Oh, Father, let family relationships, huh? Oh, Father, be healed, huh? Mamas and dads forgiving one another, huh? Oh, Father, they reconsidering before they give up, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we pray today, Father, huh? Oh, Father, for children to have families, huh? Mom and dads in the household, Father. Oh, Father, we don't want to see another broken marriage, huh? And we pray for our young men and our young women, huh? We're praying that the young men will take a stand and be fathers to their children, huh? We're praying that the young ladies, huh? Oh, Father, will be good mothers to their children, huh? Oh, Heavenly Father, we crying out today, Father, huh? For not another generation to be lost, huh? Oh, Father, we pray, hallelujah. Oh, Father, the children will receive the love that they need, my God, huh? The instruction that they need, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we thank you today, Father, for our children, huh? Oh, Father, we know they're a gift, huh? Heavenly Father, let us be faithful with the gifts that you give us, Father. Heavenly Father, we pray, Father, right now, Father. Oh, Father, for every ministry on this line today, Father. Every ministry all over the world today, Father, that don't mind lifting up the name of Jesus, huh? Oh, Father, they're doing all they know how to walk in holiness, huh? Oh, Father, for you said without holiness, no man will see you, my God, huh? Heavenly Father, so we asking you today to bless, huh? Oh, Father, to give them, Father, financial, hallelujah, overflow, huh? Oh, Father, to give them, Father, strength, hallelujah. Oh, Father, to let their families, hallelujah, be united in the churches, Lord, huh? Sitting under those with authority, Father, huh? Oh, Father, we thank you, Father, for the families in the church today, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you for all of those that you're going to send in today, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we pray to be faithful, Father. Faithful to you, my God, huh? Oh, Father, faithful in whatever you would have us to do, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we pray today, Father, to walk in obedience to your word, huh? Oh, Father, we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory, Father, for you deserve it all, my God, huh? Oh, Father, we ask you today to look down upon our military forces, Father, huh? Oh, Father, our sons and our daughters, husbands and wives, Father. Huh? Heavenly Father, in foreign lands, Lord. Huh? Heavenly Father, we're asking you, Father, to cover them, Lord. Huh? Oh, Father, let a peaceful resolution take place, Father. Huh? Oh, Father, let the leaders sit down and reason together, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we pray, Father, that they come home very soon, my God. Huh? Oh, Father, we thank you for these young men. Huh? Oh, Father, for the brave hearts of the young ladies and the young men. Huh? Oh, Father, we pray for their safe return, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, look down upon this nation, Father, huh? In this hour of chaos that is going on all around us, Lord, huh? And we trust and depend on you, Father, huh? Oh, Father, for you to offer, hallelujah. Oh, Father, of all things concerning us, Father. We thank you, Lord, hallelujah. Oh, Father, we pray for our president and his family, Father, huh? Oh, Father, we know he has a soul that needs to be saved, my God, huh? And, Father, we're asking you right now to speak to his mind, huh? Oh, Father, speak to his thought patterns, Father, huh? Oh, Father, we ask you to speak to him in dreams, Lord, huh? Oh, Father, we are praying for all of his staff, huh? Everyone that is seated in the sick, Senate, Lord, everyone that is seated in the Supreme Court, my God, oh, Father, all the lawmakers, oh, Father, let them be lawmakers and not lawbreakers, my God, Heavenly Father, we thank you today, Father, for being the almighty God that you are, Father, but we know that you rule over kings, you rule over kingdoms, my God, Heavenly Father, we pray today for a change, hallelujah, to take place, Father, a change, hallelujah, to take place, Lord, oh, Father, we cry out and we put all our trust and our hope is in you, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask you today, Father. Oh, Father, to watch over the body of Christ, Father. Strengthen us, Lord. Oh, Father, let us not have no divisions, Father. Oh, Father, that we can go forth and continue to do the work that you called us to, Father. We're praying for souls to be at it each and every day, until your kingdom, Father, and give us wisdom on how to, oh, Father, how to bless them, Father. Give us wisdom on how to teach them, Lord. Give us wisdom, Father, on how to show that love, Father, that agape love, my God. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father. Oh, Father, we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise belongs to you, Father. And Father, when we leave this line today, Father, oh, Father, let us not forget what we've heard the woman of God say. Oh, Father, she's been talking about love, Father. Oh, Father, love, Oh, Father, you commanded us to love, Father. We ought to love you with all our heart, mind, and soul, and love our neighbor as ourselves. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we ask you to forgive our enemies, all of those that despitefully use us, Lord. All of those that speak ill of us, my God. Oh, Father, for as Jesus said, they know not what they do, my God. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful woman of God, Dr. Renee Sellers. We thank you for her husband, Pastor Samuel Sellers, bringing forth commands your morning, Lord. We ask for many blessings, hallelujah, to overtake them, Lord. Oh, Father, keep them strong in their bodies, Father. Oh, Father, keep them healthy, my God. Oh, Father, say, press forward to do your will, my God. Look down upon Mr. Lee and all of his staff, Lord. Bless them, Father. Bless them for allowing these broadcasts to go forth, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you for this opportunity, Father. Heavenly Father, and we pray today, Father, that we actually demonstrate what we've heard today, Father, having no arguments with nobody, Lord, but, Father, demonstrating love, having forgiveness in our heart, Father. Oh, Father, as you said, we ought to have, my God. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, for these teachings, Father. We thank you, Lord, right now, Lord, for your word, hallelujah, never fails. Father, we give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory belongs to you. And all of these blessings we ask in your son Jesus' name, we pray. Amen, hallelujah, and it is so. And Heavenly Father, we ask today, Father, right now, if there's anyone on the line, Father, to have a heart that's made up their mind that they want to be saved, Father, we pray that when we say the salvation prayer, that they will take the opportunity and repeat after me. If it's anyone, please repeat after me. Father, it is written in your word that if I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord, and I believe in my heart that you raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. Therefore, Father, I confess that Jesus is my Lord, and I make him Lord of my life right now today. I believe in my heart that you raised Jesus from the dead. I renounce my past life with Satan and close the door to all of his devices. I thank you for forgiving me of all my sins. Jesus is my Lord, and I am a new creation. All things have passed away. Now all things have become new. In Jesus' name. If you repeated the salvation prayer after me, we say welcome to the body of Christ. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the body of Christ. You are loved, and we thank you so much for being obedient. And we say, once again, welcome. We suggest that you find a church. We pray that you will find a church where you can grow and develop to become the Christian that God desires for you to be. And at this time, we release the line back to Dr. Renee Selfish.
Amen. To God be the glory. Thank you so much, Evangelist Darlene Gant. Let's talk about love. That's what we're going to be talking about over the next few days. We talk about agape love, not just any type of love. And agape is that kind of love that gives, expecting nothing in return. It's that love that realizes the value in other people and that people are precious, ladies and gentlemen. It's not that natural kind of human love. We're going to talk about the difference one day this week between the natural human love and the agape love of Jesus Christ. That's all we have time for today. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you. Be encouraged today. Go out and love your neighbor as yourself. Love like you. Listen, love until you listen. They can't stand it no more. Love like you've never loved before. Love hard in this season, but do it with the love of Jesus Christ. The Bible declares in 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5, New Living Translation, "For every child of God defeats this evil world, and you achieve this victory through your faith. And you can win this battle against the world only those who believe that Jesus is the Son of God." If you believe that, ladies and gentlemen, you can decree and declare, "I win, I am victorious." God bless you, God keep you. Join us again tomorrow morning live at 5.
You should have been.